Hello, my dear friends, my name is Alberto. Welcome to this episode of AMP for WordPress. In the last episode, we learned that the best approach to make AMP available in WordPress in a way that is integrated with the standard content publishing workflows of the platform is by using an AMP plugin. In this episode, we are going to talk about the official AMP plugin for WordPress and learn about the capabilities that it provides out of the box for us to bring AMP into our content strategies as easily as possible. The official AMP plugin for WordPress is being developed as part of the AMP project. This means that the plugin is fully open source and is being developed by a community of contributors to the AMP project. The plugin is a powerful tool with many capabilities which can be grouped into four functional areas. First, the plugin automates as much as possible the process of generating AMP valid markup, letting you follow as close as possible the workflows that you are used to create and publish your content with WordPress. Second, the plugin provides effective validation tools to help you ensure your site remains fully AMP compatible during its life cycle. Third, the plugin provides support for AMP development to make it easier for WordPress developers to build AMP compatible components such as themes and plugins and create content with AMP compatibility built in. And fourth, the plugin supports the serving of AMP pages, allowing site owners to take advantage of features such as mobile redirection, AMP to AMP linking, minimizing leaks of AMP validation issues into Search Console, and the generation of optimized AMP by default. So, with all these capabilities, you may be asking yourself, who is the audience for the AMP plugin? Can I use it on my site? Do I need to be a developer? These are great questions, and I'm very glad you asked. The good news is that the AMP plugin can benefit everyone, regardless of technical expertise or resource availability. This means that the plugin is right for you if you are technically savvy or not. For technically savvy users, such as developers, the plugin provides powerful and effective developer tools to make it easier to build AMP compatible plugins and themes, as well as full sites. For non-developers or less tech-savvy users, or simply users that do not want to deal with validation issues, the AMP plugin allows the assembling of fully AMP compatible sites out of AMP components and provides support for coping with validation issues in easy and effective ways. Now, let's discuss in more detail some of the key capabilities of the plugin, starting with the ways in which AMP content is served for your site when you have the plugin installed. The plugin provides three different configuration options for serving AMP in your site, and we call these options template modes. Depending on the option you choose, the plugins will use one or two sets of theme templates to render your content, and you may have either your whole site on AMP or you may have an AMP version and a non-AMP version of your site. In standard mode, there is a single set of theme templates for rendering your content, and there is only one version of your site, the AMP version. This is the ideal configuration of the plugin, as your whole site is served as using AMP for both desktop and mobile visitors. This is also an easy choice if all the components used in the site, such as themes and plugins, are fully AMP compatible, or if you have the resources to do custom AMP development or fix AMP validation issues that may arise. In transitional mode, there is also a single set of theme templates for rendering your content, but in this case, there are two versions of your site, a non-AMP version, which can be served to visitors from desktop devices, and an AMP version, which can be served to visitors from either desktop or mobile devices. This is a good choice for sites that use a theme that is not fully AMP compatible, but the functional and visual difference between the AMP and non-AMP versions are acceptable. And this is also a good choice if you have the capacity to do AMP development and want to work progressively towards making your site fully AMP compatible and work towards switching to standard mode, which is the ideal scenario. Finally, in reader mode, there are two different sets of theme templates for rendering your content, and there are also two versions of your site, a non-AMP version, which can be served to visitors from desktop devices, and an AMP version, which can be served to visitors from mobile devices. This mode may be selected if your site is using a highly AMP-incompatible theme and you are not technically savvy, or when you simply don't want to deal with incompatibilities and prefer to have a simplified workflow to get AMP experiences to your users. This gives us a good idea about how the plugin via template mode gives you different options for taking advantage of AMP in your content strategy. In addition to these template mode configurations, the plugin provides key functionality that allows you to control all the aspects of the AMP power experience you bring to your users. CSS is at the core of web content creation and publishing, together with HTML and JavaScript. But improper use of CSS can also be a source of bad performance. And to prevent this from happening, AMP imposes certain constraints on the use of CSS. For example, it imposes a limit of 75 kilobytes for the amount of CSS that can be used on any given page. Only animations that are run on GPUs, graphical processing units, can be used. And it also forbids the use of certain CSS components, such as some add rules and the exclamation important property. And the AMP plugin provides support to make it easier to keep your site pages in good CSS shape by doing two things: CSS processing and CSS tree shaking. On the CSS processing side, the plugin transforms the important qualifiers into rules with highly specific selectors. It removes disallowed add rules and also removes disallowed CSS properties, and also serializes and parses CSS into a minimized form and caches it so the processing doesn't have to be repeated if nothing changes on a given page. This functionality of the plugin is super helpful, especially in cases where you want to make an existing page or existing site fully incompatible. Now, in addition to the restrictions on certain CSS components, we also need to keep the size of the CSS in our site up to a maximum of 75 kilobytes for any given page. This sometimes is very difficult, not because 75 kilobytes is not enough, but because it's easy to keep adding CSS rules to our pages, even when often those rules are not used at all. And finding out which CSS rules are used and which are not can be very challenging. To help us with this, the AMP plugin implements what is called a CSS tree shaking algorithm, which simply means that it traverses the CSS tree for any given page and removes as much unused CSS as possible. Taking advantage of AMP on a site is not an all or nothing proposition. Instead, we can use AMP in a flexible way and incorporate it into our content strategy progressively. The AMP plugin gives us such flexibility by allowing us to select which part of the site should be served as AMP and which should not. Remember that, as we discussed back in episode number 2, it is super important for our sites to perform well and provide great experiences to all our users. But offering good performance is especially vital for users that visit our site from mobile devices. And this is the case because more often than not, mobile devices have limited capacity in terms of memory, CPU, and also the networks that they run on have limited bandwidth and poor reliability often. Therefore, the impact of bad performance on user experience is amplified on mobile devices. To ensure our mobile users get an AMP power user experience, when the official AMP plugin is configured in transitional or reader mode, you can automatically redirect mobile users to the AMP version of your site. Also, together with mobile redirection, the plugin enables AMP to AMP linking, allowing your mobile visitors to stay on an AMP version of your site once they land on any AMP page. The WordPress ecosystem has been moving steadily towards more AMP compatibility, and the number of both AMP compatible ecosystems, components, and sites is growing as we speak. But the WordPress ecosystem is vast, and therefore there are cases where we need to address incompatibilities in components of our site, either by suppressing the incompatible elements, not using a given plugin, or doing some AMP development to make components fully AMP compatible. The good news is that the official AMP plugin provides a lot of support for debugging AMP incompatibilities when they happen, including mechanisms for identifying the validation issues that exist, contextualizing them, which means finding out which components of our site are responsible for the issues, and dealing effectively with them. These capabilities make it way easier for users to keep their sites uncompatible and for developers to build uncompatibility into their components. We will learn much more about unplugging developer tools in the next episode. We covered a lot. The unplugging places all of these capabilities at your fingertips, making it easier for you as a content creator to incorporate AMP into your content strategy. In the next episode, we will get our hands on the AMP plugin and see how these capabilities can be configured and activated to get you going with AMP as quickly as possible for your site. So stay tuned, don't forget to click on the subscribe button and enable notifications, and let's make it happen.